Hi students, today onwards we are going to start our online lessons. Now, I am going to teach science lesson 1, food, where does it come from? Normally we are eating food daily, or what is food? Everyone knows what is food, but do we know the definition of food? A substance which gives energy and keeps the body in good health is called food. What is food? A substance which gives energy and keep the body in good health is called food. What is the benefits of eating the foods? Food keeps us energy, it gives us healthy, that's why we should eat healthy food. Or there is a lot of variations in the food eaten in different regions of India. Normally, in our daily life, whatever food we are eating, do you think about that? Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That food is also different from each other. Breakfast are different from lunch. Or we are not eating same food again and again. There, the food, the material needed to prepare a dish is called its ingredients. Each and every food ingredients are different. The materials which we are using to prepare the food is called its ingredients. Here, for example, idli. Idli, for preparing idli, we are using rice, udad dal, salt, water, etc. Here, rice and udad dal. This we are getting from plants. So, these are the plant product. And I have one more example. Here, see this picture. This is cake pieces. Can you say which ingredients are used there to prepare the cake? Here, maida is using, or dry fruits are there. Dry fruits are there, or butter is using to prepare the cake. Here maida is the pan product, or butter. From where butter is getting? Butter is getting from milk. Milk is the animal product, but maida is the plant product, and dry fruits are using in it. The dry fruits are plant products. Or here one cup of tea is here. What are the ingredients to prepare the tea? Milk, sugar, tea powder. These we are using to prepare the tea. There, milk is the milk. From where does we are getting milk? From this milk giving animals, cow, goat, etc. So milk is the plant product, and sugar, so milk is the animal product. Milk is the animal product. Now, here sugar is using to prepare the tea. Sugar is a plant product. Sugar is getting from the plant. Or tea powder. Tea powder is also from plant. So, sugar and tea powder is a plant product. And normally, these ingredients we are using, these ingredients are getting from plants or animals. Here, next one, food from plants. Which food items we are getting from plants? For example, fruits. Fruits, apple, mango, not only that, chili, brinjal, drumstick, etc. are known as the fruits of the plant. Next one, roots. Carrot, radish, etc. are the roots of the plants. Next one, stem. Example, sugar cane. Flower, cauliflower we are using, or banana flower is also using as the dish. Next one, leaves. spinach we are using as the food, or coriander leaves, etc. we are using as the dish. Apart from this animal, apart from this plant products, we are getting food from animals also. Food from animals are example, milk, eggs, meat, fish, honey, etc. we are getting from animals. Now you are thinking, honey is the animal product. From where does honey comes? From where does we are getting this honey? See this picture. This is a honey bee. It's collecting nectar. Nectar means sweet juice. It is collecting sweet juice from the flower, and it converts into honey, and it collect it in their honeycomb, beehive. Then human beings collected that honey from their beehive. Like that way we are getting honey. So honey is getting from honeybee. So this honey is known as the animal product. Honey is the animal product. Then food for animals. Apart from human beings, animals also needed food. We can divide the animals into three groups as per their food. As per their food, we can bifurcate the animals into three groups. First one, herbivorous animals. Herbivorous animals means animals which eat only plants and plants part. Such type of animals are called herbivores. Example, cow, goat, etc. Here, some more picture. This elephant. Elephant eats only plants, plant part of the plants it is eating. That's why it is called herbivores. Next, giraffe. This also eats plants only, so this also called herbivorous animals. This is considered in the group of herbivores. Next one, carnivorous animals. What are carnivorous animals? Animals which eat other animals. They kill other animals and the flesh of the other animals. Such animals are called carnivorous animals. Example, lion, tiger, etc. are the carnivorous animals because they are eating only flesh of other animals. Here, tiger is there, lion. These are the carnivorous animals. Such ways, so many animals are there, only eating other animals. Such are called carnivorous animals. Next, third one is omnivores. Omnivores animals. They are animals which eat both plants and animals. Plants parts also they are eating. Animals also they are eating other animals also. Example, dog, cat, etc. We human beings also, are also included in omnivores group. Here some more example. Here peacock. They are eating grains and snakes, other insects also. So this is an omnivorous animal. Here, this is bear. This also eating both plants products and animals also. So this is also included in the omnivorous group. These three types of animals are there. So I hope you all understand whatever I taught today. Food. Main is food. Food gives us energy to keep our body in good health. And here we are consuming many parts of the plants, fruits, roots, stem, flowers, leaves, etc. as the plant parts we are consuming. Then food from animals we are getting food from animals also. And as per the animals are divided into three groups. They are herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Today, this much is there, and homework is given in that note. And you have to write the points in your CW book, and homework is also given there. And today's section is over, and next session, we'll explain the question answers and everything. Okay, thank you.